Hey everyone, Shaedow here, and welcome to another Marvel Contest of Champions video. So we're going to be going through Act 7, Chapter 3, Quest Number 1. We're just starting 7.3, and this is not a guide, I have to say that. It is a walkthrough, it's my initial clear, so you're going to see the path that I considered the easiest path for completion. And we'll go through each of the fights, and then we'll talk about the boss, and I'll walk you through all of that. All right, so the path that I chose for my initial clear is this path here that starts with Thor, Jane Foster. And this one has the power shield, has the special delivery, and it has the hurt locker. Matador as well, and special one bias. I consider this path to be the easiest path initially. Now, what you want to do is go through all the paths, look at your own roster, and see what you think might be easier for you. You might do this path. I think it's a great path for Ghost. So you're going to see me using Ghost mostly, but I don't use Ghost for every single fight, but I do use her for most of it. So the tricky part about these fights here is the special delivery. So you see that I have 7, 6, you see it counting down, 5. You have to fire off a special before that gets to 0. Okay? And so here we go. I have 2. Boom. Don't ask me how I missed that first hit, but I did get my special 2 off. Now you see a 2 up there. So I need to alternate. I need to either fire a special 1 or a special 3. Safer for me to fire the special 1. So that's what I did. Now, there's a 1 up there, so the next one has to be a special 2. Or 3. Alright, not so easy to get a special 3 with the Matador. So what I'm going to do here is 1 hit, push her right there, bait out that one, and boom. Very quick, simple, easy, but you have to keep track of that. Now, one of the things that will happen if you don't manage the special delivery, and later on, I do mess up, you'll take some damage. You're gonna take some degen damage. Now, with Ghost, because I have Hood on the team, I shouldn't take any damage while I'm phased. But if you're using anybody else, so for this path, if you don't have Ghost, for example, you can do this path with pretty much anyone, and the power shield is going to double, you know, or I forget how much it is, but it's going to increase your damage considerably. So you want to go in with somebody that has some really high damage specials and use them. Ghost, obviously. She's got crazy crits, you know, if you play her right on her specials and all of that. But just anybody that has really powerful specials would be good for this path here. But anybody can do it. It just might take you a little bit longer. That's all. I don't like long fights, so I want to go with somebody. Did y'all see that? 102k crit. But anyway, I want to go in with somebody that is going to get the path done pretty quickly. So that's pretty much the strategy all the way up to the boss. See how quick we're just chewing through them, right? Love Ghost, love Ghost. So next fight is Masakri. Let me see, who did I use for him? Yeah, okay, I still use Ghost. I will use Black Widow. She's another very good option for this, and you'll see why. I'll talk more when I actually use her. But for now, you know, just have to make sure I manage that special delivery. And there we go. Now I need to build up to a special 2. All right, so I don't want to push him to a special 2. I want to bait out special ones just like that so that I'll be able to get my special two off. Look at those crits. Woo! 80k crits. That's for that power shield. Loving it. I'm using my 6-star ghost, even though my 5-star is max sig, because of this path, it doesn't matter. Matador means it doesn't matter, you know, her sig ability, you know, it doesn't really matter for this. Okay? So, just tearing them up. I just love watching Ghost just tear them up. I know some people get bored with Ghost, so I try not to use Ghost all the time, but if she's the best option, I'm gonna use her. All right, so this one, I didn't want to use Ghost because it's Magneto and I didn't want to be magnetized, all that good stuff. So I came in here with Clairvoyant, Black Widow Clairvoyant. Now, the thing with her is that if you play it right, you can end this with full health. Because of Power Shield, she's going to be doing a lot more damage on her special. So if you get, see, I got caught there, but all I have to do is cycle to her blood phase and just keep firing off special twos and just watch what happens. See, right there, I decided to block a lot of it, so I didn't want to get one shot. All right, so there we go with the special one, and he is definitely, you know, they had the node where he's gonna fire special ones off more often. All right, now watch this. Look at the health. That is why she's such a good option for this path. Because of Power Shield, she does a lot more damage. Just look at this. All right, and he's just firing those things off like they're going out of style. All right, now watch this here. Another one. Look at the health. Boom, we're back to full. And that's pretty much how you can do it. You don't have to evade that if you don't really want to. You can take the block damage and just heal it back up. Okay, so here, look at it, he's just firing it off, but that's okay. Because then I can just do this and get back all of the health he just stole. Give back what you stole. Like, boom. That's the special one. Boom. Man, he's just trying to catch me, boy. Just look at that. Come on. Get it up. Give it up. Okay. And boom. Finish the fight with full health. That is how you play Black Widow Clairvoyant for this path. So if you have Black Widow Clairvoyant, you can do this path very nicely and safely. You got Ghost, you can do it very nicely and safely. But like I said, anybody that has strong specials will work. Even if they don't have strong specials, the fight will just go a little bit longer. Now, I was worried about this fight because Tigra can be very tricky, especially because she has that double medium there, you see? So you have to wait a little bit when you're using Ghost before you attack. See? And so now I'm trying to bait that special out. We were lucky she fired it off, and I want to get her back. So I fired off my special one, and look how much damage it did. Okay, so now she seems to be calming down a little bit. And I just want to get that special two off. All right, so now we want to bait it out. Thanks to the node, she is more likely to fire the special one. There we go. Now here, see, I messed up. That's why I took all that damage. I messed up, I hit, and the special delivery counter went down, and then I went right into my special instead of phasing, so I was taking all that damage. I would have taken more damage, but she got knocked out before I finished it. Now, this fight, I could have done it with Ghost. I could have done it with Clairvoyant, but I wanted to bring Hood in here just for a little variety, okay? So I'm just like, yeah, this should be good, but Hood doesn't have really, really powerful specials. But this is a good example of what I mean by you can do this with pretty much anybody. It would just be a little bit longer fight. Okay, so there, I messed up again on the special delivery. Wasn't paying attention. Okay, but with against Hyperion, it's really easy because he has a power gain, right? But Hood staggers a lot of it. So it made it a little bit more difficult. So while I did want to use Hood in this fight, it was actually somewhat counterproductive because I would stagger the power gain. So he wasn't gaining it the way that I, you know, would have liked. So I could just keep baiting it out, firing my special. Okay. So here we go. Look at that. That's how it should be. Just keep baiting them out. But because Hood, I was basically fighting this like I was trying to control his power. But that's not really what you want to do in this case, because the node means he's more likely to fire his special one. So it's going to be easier to bait that special one out. But as you can see, Hood is working, you know, slowly, but he's working. I just have to remember to alternate. Okay, so at this point here, you know, I'm trying to watch the special delivery. We're down to 6, okay? And then we're down to 4. I pushed it, 2, but hit one more. Now what I need to do is bait it out. Now I need to intercept him with my special because I don't want to hit him. There we go. See, if I had hit him, I would have taken that degen just like I did with Ghost in the other fight. So this time, I was like, okay, and I wouldn't have even had to hit him that one more time because he gets power gain as long as I hadn't staggered it. So, you know, whoever you use on this one, just keep that in mind. Ghost, I could have just not even worried about it. Let him fire off whatever he wanted to fire off. But yeah, the only tricky thing is to keep, you know, track of the special delivery and keep track of your specials. But it's nice because they have the number up there so you know what special you did last. So you don't really have to keep track. You can just look up there and be like, okay, I got to do a special one right now. Okay, so here we go. Good. Now I can do a special 2, but he wasn't going to live that long. So a little bit of a longer fight, but it did show that you can do this path with almost anybody. You just have to keep track of those things. All right, so I believe that was it for that path. He was the final one on the path. Now, the boss that I chose was Ultron. And you see that I brought with me Magneto. But since I'm not going to use, you know, some of the other ones, I said, you know what? Let me go ahead and bring in 2 Magnetos just in case, right? And who to replace? Who to replace? Hood. You know? So you're going to see something happen in this fight that really got me upset. It got me upset. I have fought this guy many times. I fought him with Magneto. Magneto is like the ideal counter for this fight. Very, very simple. Magneto is going to shut down all of this mess so you don't have to worry about it all. He will sometimes go unblockable, but you don't have to worry about any of that stuff for the most part. You know, if he has an armor up, you want to be careful. He's going to be unblockable. All right, so I went ahead and did because I just have him in my overflow. So I wanted to use some of those up. All right, so first off, we're going to be using Magneto. And it's basic parry heavy. Now, did you see that? No parry. No parry. And I'm like, okay, fine. That failed. But all we got to do, parry heavy. Look at that. I'm like, is he unblockable? I'm sitting here seriously wondering why my parries aren't working. All right, now he's unblockable. And I'm just like, I don't believe this. Look at how I got destroyed. I could not parry. I was so ticked at this, guys. I'm looking at my health and I'm just like, okay, maybe I'll be able to get all the way up. No. I just could not parry. First parry, failed. And then I was like, okay, then I got a couple parries and then another parry failed. And I was just like, he's not even unblockable. I was looking up there and I was like, he's not unblockable. What's going on? So I said, you know what? I'm not gonna even play around. I know I wanted to just go ahead and use Magneto, but that's okay. We just bring him back Ghost. Not gonna heal her up, not gonna do anything. And I figured if Ghost don't work, then, you know, I will bring in Magneto. Now, something funny, at this point, I'm looking and I'm like, wait a minute. Y'all remember that, well, some of you may not, because by the time you watch this video, she's already fixed. But Ghost went through a period of time where you could not phase out the recoil damage. And I'm sitting here thinking, oh no, it's broken again. See, I phased, but I still took recoil damage. And I'm like, oh no. I was like, did it get rebroken? And then I remembered, oh yeah, I replaced Hood. Because I had Hood for the entire path, and then just for the boss, I swapped out Hood. And so I was like, okay. Yeah, I hate when that happens right there. But I didn't give up. I said, okay, let's just keep going. Because, I mean, he's going down. You know, whoever I got to bring in, you know, if I got to bring in the other Magneto, he's going down. You know, so I wasn't too worried about it. But, man, that was annoying. Yeah, see? Every time you see me doing that, it's because I'm just so used to it. But I realized what, you know, what was happening towards the end. We got him down, no revives, no items, so it's all good. All right, so hopefully this will help you guys when you do your initial clear. Take care. I haven't done the next ones yet, but I probably will do them at some point in time. Probably not tonight, maybe tomorrow morning. We'll see. We'll see what I do. All right, but anyway, take care, and you all have a blessed day.